Good morning, beautiful people. Welcome back to our little farm down here in Cornwall. It's very chilly, so I'm going to keep this bit really, really short because I want to get that stove on and warm up. So today we are making a Spanish chicken stew. You may have noticed I'm not Spanish. I've never actually been to Spain. Actually, that's not true. I did once go on a beer cruise from Plymouth to Santander. And I got so, so drunk with my friend and we ended up drinking with this rugby team. It got really messy. So when we actually got into Spain, they kicked us off the boat. We weren't allowed to stay on. And we just sat in port drinking water, eating paracetamol and feeling really, really sorry for ourselves. So as that is my full exposure to Spain, obviously this is not an authentic Spanish chicken stew. This is just my take on a Spanish chicken stew. So I'm really sorry, Española, please don't shout at me. This one takes a little bit more cooking time than I usually allow for these recipes. So if your gas is getting a little bit low, you might not want to do this one. You can cook it to the point that it's edible quite quickly, probably in about 10 to 15 minutes. But in all honesty, to get a really nice flavour combo going on, what you really want to do is just let it simmer quite slowly for a while. You could definitely make this in a slow cooker. So if you're on electric hookup and you have a slow cooker in your van, then actually that would be perfect. I would highly recommend that. Actually, I don't know why I didn't do that. It would have saved my gas. Okay, so let's stop talking. Let's get chopping and then heating because brr. This table is so wobbly. Ah. So it's gonna slide right off, oh my goodness. In some very exciting news this week, we have just taken delivery of an oven with a grill and two gas hob rings for our new van, Vanoodle. For those of you that know him online, Rick Van Man here on YouTube, he bought this oven and hob and grill to put in his van and he had it in there for, I don't know, a couple of years, I guess. But he just didn't really use it. And obviously it's pretty bulky. It takes up quite a lot of room. So he took it out and I noticed in his latest video that he'd taken it out and put the shelving back in. And I'm like, oh, I was kind of looking at buying one of those. Are they not very good? Anyway, yeah, it's fine. It, like, you have to, the heat is a little bit fierce on one side. So you have to keep turning the food round. But yeah, he said it's fine. It's just, I don't use it. And I'm like, oh, okay. And he said, it's in my shed. Would you like to buy it, Jane? I'm like, yes, I actually really would. So yeah, we've just taken delivery of that. We've got no kitchen built yet in the new van, but we have an oven. I am so excited. And I'm also so excited about my new kitchen that I'm going to be able to stand up and chop my garlic as opposed to sitting down, because this is really quite awkward. I'm not going to lie. It's going to be great. I'm so, so excited. Right, we're going to go with a red bell pepper too. This one's looking a little bit sad. He needs to be used up. All of my veggies I'm cutting quite small just because it's going to help speed up the cooking time is all. If you were making this in the slow cooker, I would recommend having bigger chunks of vegetables. I think actually that would be really, really nice. When I was chatting with Rick after the oven had been delivered, I told him that when we're on the road, we're going to drive up to his town. I'm going to cook him dinner in his oven. And I think he said that he'd only ever cooked frozen chips in the oven. So it won't be frozen chips, Rick, just so you know. Oh my gosh, it's so, so cold. And I have part of a chorizo. Mmm, smells so good. So a nice big dolloping lump of that. I'm lactose intolerant and most chorizo has lactose in as an actual added ingredient, which obviously I can't tolerate. Right, that is the chopping stuff done. So to start with, I'm just going to add a little bit of oil, my rock solid, I think this is actually frozen ghee now, just a little bit of that in there, just to kind of make the pan a bit slidey. And then I'm going to pop my chorizo in just to get that cooking down because this contains quite a lot of oil. So that will start to render out and then that's going to help flavour the rest of the dish. Oh goodness, that smells delicious. And can you see the oil that's starting to come out? That's chorizo is flavoured with smoked paprika, which is why you get that lovely orange oil. And that's one of the benefits of using chorizo as a flavouring meat in a dish. So what I can now do is add in my onions and my red pepper. And if I was cooking this at home and had more time, then I would have put the onions in first so that they can soften down. But I'm really thinking about the amount of gas that this is going to use, so I'm keeping it quite quick. And to help this cook even quicker, I'm just going to get you guys out of the way so I can get into that cupboard and get the lid for that pan, because that will really help hold the heat and the steam in, which will help speed up the cooking too. So excuse me, bear with. And it also makes it a lot quieter in here, which is good when you've got a camera on. So I'm just going to let that cook for 2 or 3 minutes just to really start breaking down those vegetables and making them a lot softer. And I guess now would be a good time to try and find a can opener. Oh, yes we do. Give it a stir every now and then just to make sure it's not going to burn. Now, I've written the full recipe, which is over on the website if you actually want to go and read the full recipe. The recipe calls for 4 chicken thighs that are skinless and boneless. The pack that I bought actually had 6 in, so I'm kind of bumping up the amount of food I'm making here, so it's not specifically following that recipe. So if you need to actually read a recipe to like recreate a dish, then please follow the link down in the description box below and you'll find it all very clearly written out. And if you're the type of person that just wings recipes, fair play to you. You get the drift, right? Okay, now they're really sweated down, I'm going to pop in my garlic too. This is going to be one of those dishes that make your campsite neighbours very jealous. This smells amazing. Oh my goodness, that is looking delicious. How yummy? Right, let's get our chicken in now. Oh my gosh, is this even going to fit in this pan? There's so much of it. That's a lot of chicken. Right, that's our chicken tossed around in all those yummy oils and flavours too. Now I'm going to add in a can of chopped tomatoes. And yes, it's really out of date. Also going to add the water. And if you happen to have boiled a kettle first, that would be much better, because I've now just taken the temperature in my pan right down by using very cold water. And I'm going to add in a stock cube, and the only stock cubes I have in my house, apparently a beef. We're going to pretend that this is a chicken stock cube. Okay, I tell you what, the level of professionalism on this cooking channel is just, it's off the chart. If you're new to this channel, you might not know, I actually have a TV show. Can you even believe that? What were they thinking? Giving me a TV show. Oh my goodness. Where's my wet wipe gone? All right, now we need to pop that lid on. We need to kick back and relax, because that now just needs time. I'm going to give it probably 10 minutes. I will stir it a couple of times in that 10 minute period. But yeah, it's going to need a good little while just to simmer for all those flavours to come together, for the chicken to get nice and cooked and soft, to really finish off softening down those veggies. And I think it's going to be a good one. And also it'll give me time to sit up straight, which is always a good thing. Yeah. No rest for the wicked. Forgot to put my smoked paprika in. Delicious. Oh. Well, that's going to be a pain, because that is hot. Oh, now that bit's fallen out, honestly. Okay, now we'll leave it for 10 minutes. Let's pop our olives in before I eat any more. The olives are optional. Johnny will not eat an olive in this dish. He will pick them all out, bless him. But if you don't like olives, then obviously please don't add them in. But they're good for you and I love them. So they're going in. Sorry, Johnny. I also have a pouch of microwavable rice. You need to kind of give it a good old rub down to break up any lumps that are in there. You don't need to add this. If you'd like to keep it low carb, then obviously omit the rice. But I kind of fancy making a proper hearty meal here, so I'm just going to pop that in as well. And if you're making this dish in the slow cooker or at home on the hob or whatever, you can obviously use normal rice, dried rice. because it will take just a little bit longer to cook. It will soak up more of the moisture, so you will need to add more water into the pan as well. So I'm just going to mix that round, and we are so nearly done, my lovelies. Doesn't that look delicious? Yummy. Right, I'm just going to give it a taste and then season with salt and pepper if it needs it. And the black pepper, rather than grinding that over there, the steam will get in there and gunk it all up. So I'm just going to grind it into my hand. Now, I don't know about you, I reckon that looks well tasty. Alrighty, well, I'm excited. Oh, that should do me. I think it's about half nine in the morning. I haven't eaten any breakfast because I knew I was going to be cooking this morning. So this is actually going to be my breakfast. Not all of this. I was joking, I promise. And then if you want to look all fancy and Instagram worthy, you need to put a nice little bit of contrasting green onto your red dish. So I've got some chopped flat leaf parsley. So just a nice sprinkle of that over the top. And then you can dive in. So this is way too much food for two people now. And I think you could, this is certainly enough for three. I think you could even stretch this out to feed four people. And especially if you had a nice fresh baguette on the side, definitely. But you could use the bread to mop up the juices, and that along with the rice would keep you really, really, yeah. I think that would be the way to go. Okay, I'm just gonna have a little taste test because I know you're all dying to know what it tastes like. So I've got an olive, oh, parsley, hang on. That is really nice, really nice. And I think that if you were to cook this in the slow cooker or give it like a good 40 minutes cooking time, I think the sauce would become more syrupy. It would have more mouthfeel. But saying that, the sauce in this isn't thin. It's actually extremely good. I haven't tried cooking this in a slow cooker. So if you guys do, and you do it this way, you'll have to let me know which one you prefer. Right, beautiful people, that's me done for another week. I hope you've enjoyed this video. And if you have, please wallop the thumbs up for me because it really helps my channel out. And if you want more ideas for really quick and easy one pot meals that you can cook on a stove and soon that you'll be able to cook in an oven, then don't forget to subscribe to the channel and ding the bell, and then you'll get notified each time we upload our latest video. And if you are new around here, then let me just drop into the conversation that I have a couple of ebooks as well that are packed with easy one pot recipes that you can cook on a hob in a camper van or in your kitchen or wherever. I'll leave links to both of those below. And also, if you sign up to my newsletter, you actually get a free little ebook which gives you a load of recipes using instant noodles. We ditch that little flavor sachet that comes with the instant noodles and we pimp them with some other yummy things, but super quick, really, really tasty. Yeah, I think you'll enjoy them. Right, I'm out of here. Me and my breakfast have a date, so I will catch up with you guys next Friday. Until then, mwah! Happy camping.